this broadcast.
We interrupt this broadcast to bring you this important bulletin from the United Press. Flash, Washington.
We interrupt our program to bring you a special broadcast. The German news agency...
We interrupt this program to bring you a news bulletin from Washington. The White House...
Holding it just enough to keep it from...
The first and the flash. Get this started. It's rising terrible. Oh, my. Get out of the way, please. It's burning, bursting into flames, and it's falling on the morning fast, and all the folks agree that this is terrible. This is one of the worst catastrophes in the world. Oh, it's 400 or 500 feet into the sky. It's a terrific crash, ladies and gentlemen. The smoke and the flames now, and the flame is rising to the ground, not quite to the mooring mast. Oh, the humanity and all the passengers screaming around here. I can't talk, ladies and gentlemen.
We interrupt this broadcast to bring you this important bulletin from the United Press. Flash, Washington. The White House announces Japanese attack on Pearl Harbor. Stay tuned to WOR for further developments.
We interrupt this program to bring you a special broadcast. Here's the bulletin. Washington, the President decided today after Japan's attack on Pearl Harbor and Manila to call an extraordinary meeting of the Cabinet for 8:30 p.m. tonight, and to have congressional leaders of both parties join the conference at 9 p.m. And now we take you to Honolulu.
Bring you a special broadcast. The German news agency Transocean said today in a broadcast that the Allied invasion had begun. I repeat, the German news agency Transocean said today in a broadcast that the Allied invasion had begun. There was no Allied confirmation.
Soldiers, sailors, and airmen of the Allied Expeditionary Force, you are about to embark upon the great crusade toward which we have striven these many months. The eyes of the world are upon you. The hopes and prayers of liberty-loving people everywhere march with you.
This nation has suffered this day a staggering loss. At this moment at Warm Springs, Georgia, President Franklin D. Roosevelt lies with the problems of the nation finally lifted from his shoulders, stricken late this afternoon with cerebral hemorrhage. He passed away before his physicians could be of any assistance, if assistance in such a case is possible at all. But Franklin D. Roosevelt, the first president to be elected for four terms in the White House, has passed away, and that is the overshadowing of all news events that have happened or can happen for quite a while.
This is a solemn but a glorious hour. I only wish that Franklin D. Roosevelt had lived to witness this day. General Eisenhower informs me that the forces of Germany have surrendered to the United Nations. The flags of freedom fly all over Europe. The world will note that the first atomic bomb was dropped on Hiroshima, a military base. We won the race of discovery against the Germans. We have used it in order to shorten the agony of war, in order to save the lives of thousands and thousands of young Americans. We shall continue to use it until we completely destroy Japan's power to make war.
Broadcasting to you from the White House grounds. Have you heard the flash? I am sure. The Japanese offer of unconditional surrender is official. It has been accepted. President Truman said this: I have received this afternoon a message from the Japanese government in reply to the message forwarded to that government by Secretary of State Burns on August 11th. I deem this reply, the President told us, a full acceptance of the Potsdam Declaration, which specified the unconditional surrender of Japan.
There's nothing but excitement and love of the moment in the air. They won't let me sleep.
Godspeed, John Glenn.
Roger, the clock is operating. We're underway.
Be loud and clear.
Roger, we're programming and roll okay. A little bumpy along about here.
Roger, 0G, and I feel fine. Capsule is turning around. Oh, that view is tremendous.
Good evening, my fellow citizens. This government, as promised,
has maintained the closest surveillance of the Soviet military buildup on the island of Cuba. Within the past week, unmistakable evidence has established the fact that a series of offensive missile sites is now in preparation on that imprisoned island. The purpose of these bases can be none other than to provide a nuclear strike capability against the Western Hemisphere. Should these offensive military preparations continue, thus increasing the threat to the hemisphere, further action will be justified. I have directed the armed forces to prepare for any eventuality. It shall be the policy of this nation to regard any nuclear missile launched from Cuba against any nation in the Western Hemisphere as an attack by the Soviet Union on the United States, requiring a full retaliatory response upon the Soviet Union. I call upon Chairman Khrushchev to halt and eliminate this clandestine, reckless, and provocative threat to world peace and the stable relations between our two nations. I call upon him further to abandon this course of world domination and to join in an historic effort to end the perilous arms race and to transform the history of man.
Here's another late development, and this news keeps coming in as we're talking here. President Kennedy, according to the Associated Press, and Texas Governor John Connally were shot from ambush today in Dallas, Texas, and it is not known whether either Mr. Kennedy or Governor Connally were killed. Here's other information, Justin, from the correspondents traveling with the presidential party. It says President Kennedy apparently was shot in the head.
An important bulletin. President Kennedy was given blood transfusions just a few moments ago at Parkland Hospital in an effort to save his life.
From Dallas, Texas, the flash, apparently official, President Kennedy died at 1 p.m. Central Standard Time, 2 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, some 38 minutes ago.
Report from Dallas, Texas. The accused assassin of President Kennedy, Lee Harvey Oswald, was shot today just after leaving the police booking office in the Dallas City Hall.
We have just received a confirmed report from Parkland Hospital that Lee Harvey Oswald has died. Lee Harvey Oswald, the man who assassinated President Kennedy on Friday, is dead. This is a confirmed report from Parkland Hospital in Dallas, Texas. Bob Jett, Mutual News, Dallas reporting.
Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. was shot outside a Memphis motel this afternoon. His condition is not known at this time. Police put out a wanted bulletin for, quote, a young white male, well-dressed, who was seen running from a brick building across the street from the Lorien Hotel. Police said the assailant apparently jumped into a late model white car after the shooting and sped away.
I know that every American of goodwill joins me in mourning the death of this outstanding leader and in praying for peace and understanding throughout this land.